Well, here we are, day five, I believe, August 30th, and this is the day my mom has been waiting for. We are doing a Hawaii 5-0 tour. So we are ready. We ate breakfast. She is singing, and we're heading out. And yeah, let's do this.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hi there. It's time for another day in paradise.
Day five. Let's do this. It is Wednesday and we're going on a Hawaii 5-0 tour.
Mom is happy. Mom is happy.
Just got out. We made it in time. We're doing good on time. So we're gonna go get a Starbucks.
So what'd you get?
We got our fuel for Hawaii 5-0 tour. Pumpkin cream cold brew.
So
I asked the worker, I was like, can you get a pumpkin spice with the cold brew in it? And then I realized, okay, they already have it. So I'm on vacation, aloha, so what can I say? So, yes, so cheers.
Is this our first Starbucks in Hawaii?
It is.
So today's a big deal. We are at the Ala Moana.
We've had such great coffee.
Yes, we're at the Ala Moana Hotel, awaiting our Hawaii 5-0 tour. And I don't know a better way to start out your day than Starbucks.
Yes.
In Honolulu.
Yes, in Honolulu. I got a Waikiki mug, so for Waikiki in Honolulu. In Hawaii.
Are you ready for the 5-0 tour?
Oh, we are ready. We are
fun.
I hope I know some of this stuff. everyone here a fan of the show, Hawaii 50?
Yes.
Yes. We have the biggest fan right here.
Yes, there she
oldest.
Is.
Okay, no, the oldest man.
The greatest.
And did we watch both Hawaii 50?
Yes, of course. That's what she I grew has, up on. Yes. It's Jack Lord.
Okay, we will touch on both shows
today. Yay.
Woo-hoo.
Does everyone here know why they film so many things in Honolulu or on this island?
No.
First and foremost, we have 11 of the world's 13 climates, so they can make it look like just about anywhere in the world.
Oh.
Also, we have no critters in Hawaii. Do you know that?
No.
You know what I mean when I say no critters?
Snakes?
No snakes, no tarantulas, no lions, tigers, or bears, or foxes, or coyotes, or raccoons, or skunks, or poison oak, poison ivy, no ticks and chiggers to have to worry about, no alligators, crocodiles, piranhas, leeches, none of those things. It's anxiety-free.
So
if you're going to film a Vietnam War movie, would you rather do it in Vietnam or would you rather do it here where you have to not worry about any of that stuff?
It's a no-brainer.
And we have the huge movie studio that's right near Diamond Head, so they don't have to ship the equipment in from other places. It already exists here, you know, so it saves with their production costs as well.
So why do they call it Diamond Head?
That's a great question. Actually, when Captain Cook, British explorer, first came to the Hawaiian Islands, he saw these little sparkles in the mountain and he thought, oh my gosh, it's diamonds, we're rich. And it turned out to just be mineral crystals from the lava.
Oh.
So that's kind of how it got its nickname. Okay, all the high-end stores can be found here on this section of Kalakaua Avenue. And we have a lot of busiest in the world. Like this cheesecake factory here is the busiest cheesecake factory in the world.
Wow.
We also have the Outrigger Waikiki. They have Blue Note in this hotel, which is where they do a lot of live musical acts and comedy shows and everything else. And then this is the very first hotel built in the state of Hawaii here to your right. This is called the Moana Surf Rider, and it was built in the year 1901. And one of the bellmen here at this hotel is actually Bruno Mars's uncle, and I'm not kidding. Okay, main portion of Waikiki Beach is here to your right. Kohio Beach here, Queens Beach here. But this is actually the birthplace of surfing. This is where it was invented about 700 years ago. And it was a sport that was reserved for people of royal blood. So if you got caught swimming or surfing out here 700 years ago and you didn't have royal blood, they would reprimand you by possibly breaking a bone, which they don't do anymore. So we tell people to take advantage of the situation. But right now we're going towards Dano's lookout. Are you guys familiar with where Dano would go to contemplate life and try and figure out what's going on with him? Sometimes his daughter would join him, but...
Oh, yes.
In real life though, guys, this is actually some of our makeout spots. We all have these lovers points around the world, and this is one of ours here, but only because of the beautiful views that you get, really. This side step down.
Oh, look at you. Oh my goodness.
I feel like I'm Miss America. Come here, Miss World. Come here. To Hawaii.
Can the words sound till you've been down so long? The future's bright, lit up with nowhere to go. To and fro. Here and then we go.
Hey. Hey. Flight landed hours ago. I swung by your place, tried calling you a bunch.
Yeah, I didn't feel like going home yet, you know?
Yeah, I figured. I figured, then I remembered you telling me about this place, that it was a special spot for you.
This is also Dano's spot, right?
Yes.
So right here is where he sits. This is the backdrop that you see when they film those scenes as well. So if it looks familiar to you, you saw it on the show Hawaii 5-0, right?
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
Just saw it the other day.
We gotta sit. We gotta get
I want to sit.
Normally on a clear day, you would look along the horizon here and you would see the next island over, but because it's so windy today, the salt air is kind of hindering our visibility, so the closest island to us is the island of Molokai, which is approximately 42 miles away in the far eastern corner of our island where I'm pointing at right now.
Yeah.
on a really clear day, you can see the island of Maui, Lanai, and the Big Island from here too.
Wow.
So just one of those things, yeah. Okay, we do have two dormant volcanic craters in this direction as well. Can you guys see them?
Yeah.
So the one on the right there is a place called Coco Crater. Has anyone heard of Coco Crater before?
I've heard of it.
You have? So Coco Crater is the backside of a place called Hanama Bay. Have you heard of Hanama Bay?
Yes.
So that's also on the top five things to do while on the island of Oahu. And when you swim there, it's like you're in a big fish tank, really. It's a fish sanctuary.
Oh, that's cool.
From the shoreline to the barrier reef is maybe 2 to 6 feet deep. You're not a strong swimmer. You put your mask on, you walk to where it's 4 feet deep, you look at all the fish, and then you just stand up. So it's easy for people of all swimming abilities, really, right?
That's good to know.
And then the crater to the left over there, that's the one where you would see Alex walking up and down that train track looking
thing. Yes.
So that's Coco Crater.
A few weeks ago that spot, and I thought, I wonder if there's a chance I might see that in Hawaii. And the chance happened. Yes, I saw it.
How many, multi of the same vehicles do they have?
Or they have four of the Camaros, four of the Silverados. Just if they're filming in multiple locations, you have the same car ready to go, so it doesn't hold up production. Okay, this is the film studio to your right, guys. So as you can see, nothing's being done right now. They're probably moving some furniture from the inside of sets to another location. You see this little kiosk here? So while they were filming here in Hawaii, if you were to come on set and you were going to be an extra or whatever, they would make you test negative for COVID prior to going in. So that's kind of what that was. And then this little small kiosk thing. And then this building in front of us is the casting offices. A lot of tourists or fans of the shows that they would film here would actually sign up to be extras while on vacation. Because who better to play tourist than tourists, right? They would say, hey, bring your empty luggage to the Hilton Hawaiian Village lobby. We'll be filming there from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m.
That's so cool.
You
know, I want to be there.
You walk across the lobby with your empty luggage and cut. So they're lucky if they see your left earlobe in one shot. But here's the main entrance to get into the Diamond Head Crater here. That was the main road that we just passed there. Across the street from the studio. Also, you see these old rusted roof buildings in front of us here, guys? A lot of this is also utilized by the studios. So the inside of the headquarters for Hawaii 5-0, where they filmed a lot of those scenes, and also some of the inside of the McGarrett House, was actually filmed in this green, old, rusted roof building that's just to our left, right there. Can you see that building?
Yeah.
Also behind that parking lot is where they store a lot of the cars that they use for the show. Like Kamekona Shrimp Truck is back there.
We're doing great. Oh yeah, that's so pretty.
Right here, this is the McGarrett House, otherwise known as the Bear Estate, okay? While they were filming here, you would have police in the front, and then you'd have all the movie trucks lined up nice and neat here. Behind the white truck is where they would position craft services, where they would feed all the cast and crew. And it's also where we would set up the porta potties too.
Oh. Okay.
Here it is.
It's
pretty tucked away.
Yeah, it is. Long driveway, huh?
Oh my goodness.
But this is also on the Hawaii Historic Homes list. It was built in 1936. It was developed by a person by the name of Carl Baer. Mm. He was kind of a socialite here in Honolulu. And the current owners, who are the Mirakatanis, they purchased this property in 1970. And they are nice enough to allow us to come and hang out at their house. So we're very appreciative of that. Yeah.
And they still live here?
Of course, yeah. So even while they were filming, they would just stay upstairs. You would never even know that they were here.
This is an original script from, copy, original, from Hawaii Five-O from 2020. And it's the worksheet, the...
Season 10, episode 21.
Okay. Yes. And part of the script. Wow.
It's a lot of details.
Yes, because we are at the McGarrett House. Does this remind you of kind of detail you like to do? You're used to doing? Oh, here's McGarrett says. That's it. A letter? That's what you came all this way to give her? Claypool, it's the job I was hired to do.
Wow, you're natural, my goodness.
Mr. McGarrett?
Yeah.
Michael Claypool. My apologies for being a little early. My flight landed ahead of schedule.
No problem. Please, come on in and make yourself at home. Thank you. I gotta say, it hardly seems necessary coming all the way from London for this.
Well, your mother's instructions were very clear. Following her death, I was to wait 4 months and then hand deliver this package to you.
I'm sorry, this letter, this is what you came all this way to give me?
That was the job I was hired to do. Now, I'm sure you have a very busy day ahead of you. Good day.
Yeah, okay, day. Thank you. Yes, you did eat too. And, hey, listen, safe trip home, okay?
Thank you.
All right.
You be McGarrett.
Okay, you want to do this?
No, okay. It's just...
After everything I went through, with her, all the lives and years of thinking she was dead. I just want to be done with it. The last thing I need in my life right now is another mystery.
I get it, I really do. But you honestly think you're gonna be able to leave that alone?
I beat as McGarrett considers the question. Danny. Can I ask you something else?
I'm Danny. Can I ask you something else? What are you doing here?
I woke up this morning thinking about my dad. Actually, I've been thinking about him a lot lately. It's coming up on 10 years since he died.
Didn't realize it had been that long.
So much has changed since he's been gone, especially recently. Losing Joe, my mom.
It's been a tough year, not getting around it.
It has. And yet, as much as things have changed, so much of this stays the same.
I know. Listen, why don't you sit this one out? I can handle this crime scene myself. What do you say?
Y5O McGarrett looks to Danny.
Oh, look at each other. Oh, there you go.
Appreciative of the support. I say let's go. As they head off together, camera returns to the headstone, linger on it as we... What have we got?
Assume you heard about the robbery
at Oahu National in Wapua this morning. The two armed suspects escaped after exchanging gunfire with HPD. One officer down, one killed. HPD canvassed the area, but came up with nothing. Okay, do your McGarrett.
Well, based on the turnout here, I guess she wasn't just calling with information.
Wow, you guys are naturals. That was a real life script from Hawaii 5-0. Nice work.
I mean, everything we went through with that woman, all the lies, all the years of thinking she was dead, and I want to be done with it, you know? The last thing I need in my life right now is another mystery.
Mm-hmm. Pretty sure I know you're not gonna be able to leave it alone, right?
What do you think?
Oh, let me ask you something else. Why today? Why'd you come here today?
I woke up thinking about Dad. I've been thinking about him a lot lately, I guess. I mean, it's coming up on 10 years since he died, so.
It's been 10 years.
Crazy, huh? So much has changed since he's been gone. Especially recently, losing Joe and Mom.
Yeah, it's been a tough year.
Maybe I'm just feeling a little lost right now.
That's all right. Look, why don't you take the day, relax, do what you gotta do. I'll go to the crime scene by myself. What do you say?
No, let's go. I'll drive. Hey.
Hi.
What do we got here?
Assume you heard about the robbery at Oahu National in Waipahu this morning. Two armed suspects escaped after they exchanged gunfire with HPD. One officer was killed.
HPD canvassed the area. They didn't find anything. Then, a little over an hour ago, they get a phone call from the woman who lives in this building, Sylvia Yang.
I'm assuming she wasn't just calling with information.
Acting on that will come out just right.
Mama, where are we at? Where are we at?
Hawaii.
Well,
McGarrett's house.
Did you ever think you would be in McGarrett's
no.
house?
Never dreamed that.
Say, welcome everyone. Come on
Yay.
Over.
Let's
see.
We're gonna walk to the left. We'll start with the back if that's okay, guys. Welcome.
Look who's here. We have a guest.
Oh. How's it look at?
Yeah. I'm the guy.
Yes.
I'm real. I'm not cardboard. I'm real.
Yes.
How you doing?
We're great.
Yeah.
This is awesome. We've seen you.
Yeah, I've seen you on the TV. It's on Hawaii 5-0.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yes.
Okay, everyone recognize my friend here. His name is Cousin Flip on
Absolutely.
The show.
Absolutely.
And his real name is Sean Mokuwahi Garnett. And he was a character on the show for 7 seasons. So if anyone would know the ins and outs as to what it was like being on the show or also
super
working
famous.
With some of the other characters,
international superstar.
It would be this gentleman here.
We'll try to think of questions. I'm just speechless.
Yeah? Uh-huh. All right, go on. Well, the show is for real. It was filmed in Hawaii. Yeah. Wow. And this is McGarrett's house.
Aww,
check it out.
That's so cool.
Was it fun?
Yeah. Anytime being in front of the camera.
Oh.
It's always fun.
Just like this.
It's always fun.
Did you enjoy doing it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, at first it was like, what the hell am I doing? And then all of a sudden it's just like, oh, this is what I'm doing. So I might as well get used to it.
Well, what was your favorite episode?
It was obviously the one me and Max and Kamikono was in the boat and I sunk the boat. That one, because they gave me a lot. I have no idea what season it was, but it was the one I was on the catamaran.
Okay.
And I liked it because I had more lines than usual.
Yeah.
So like I had to memorize a lot of stuff, which I was kind of nervous, but it did pretty good.
That's cool.
You had to memorize it then.
Yeah, just had to memorize it.
Thousands of years, men has taken to the sea, building vessels to conquer the mighty ocean. Now, after nearly a year of planning, months of robust pre-sale, finally time for my inaugural voyage on my latest and greatest enterprise, Kamikona, in the island, Booze Cruise.
Congratulations, big guy. We knew you could do it.
Well, not to be a killjoy, but as ship medic, I do have to advise that consuming alcohol could severely impair our ability to operate this vessel safely.
Well, as the first mate slash DJ slash bartender, I got one thing to say to that. Overruled.
I'd like to throw out a special thank you to my brother from another mother, Steve McGarrett, for generously offering his services as nautical consultant for this test run. Pro bono, I might add.
Yeah, we firmly established that I won't be getting paid, so why don't we christen this lady and get her out of the water?
Not after we blew it all on this.
Wow. Yeah, that's impressive.
Cuz is a straight-up wizard when it comes to branding.
All right. Let's make this official.
Flip-off!
What gives, bro? It's supposed to be my GPS.
All right, cuz. I got seasick.
Seawell navigation system is in the fridge.
Leaving your first mate in charge of the liquor may not have been the most prudent move.
Don't sweat it, Doc. I got an auxiliary engine just for this situation.
I assume you checked that the battery was charged before we set sail.
This thing has a battery?
Mayday. This is the SS Strong Magnet, needing emergency assistance.
And I'm afraid the radio is powered by the battery as well. And we lost cell service a few hours ago.
Why are you so calm about this?
Well, I project outward confidence as a way of coping with stress. Inside, I'm terrified.
We're gonna die out here.
Coast Guard are coming, tow us to shore. Gotta be kidding me, bro.
Must be a safety. Give it here.
Sure, let the drunk guy handle the firearm. Great idea.
Everyone chill. I got this.
Well, there's no missing that.
Watching people pass me by. Anything to pass the time. We're to think we're all the same. We're completely different. Ain't it strange, Oh, I see this world surrounding me. And I hope that someday that we can learn to love just one more day.
Wonderful!
Thanks. She's seen all the episodes. We are on season 4.
Okay.
Episode 10-ish.
Yeah, we started season 3.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I think we saw you, a little back. And I was like, oh, we're going to see
you. That's me.
So, yeah.
Didn't you start as a security guard, I believe?
Oh, yeah. I just signed up to be an extra. And then they just asked me to audition for Flip Phone. And I was like, yeah, sure.
We're looking for an older house that had lots of character. And it was supposed to be his dad's house, so they couldn't have a fancy schmancy old house, right? On a policeman's salary. But it's also oceanfront property, and so that was the main reason. They were looking at another location also in Manoa Valley, but that one was not oceanfront property, so it just didn't make sense. But when they first came here, some of the they do small weddings and events from time to time here. And one of the producers were here at an event, and they thought of this place. And so they approached the owners, and they said, hey, we're filming a show, and we'd like to use your house as the main house for the show. And she goes, well, what show is it? And they go, oh, we can't tell you. Well, then you can't use the house. And then they go, okay, it's Hawaii 5-0. And she goes, okay, now you can use the house, right? So that's kind of how it worked. Season one, they filmed everything inside.
Okay.
But after they signed up to do another 3 more seasons, they said, oh, it's a hassle for them to have to move the owner's furniture out and move their furniture in every time they filmed a scene. So they just built a set version of the inside of the house at the movie studio that we passed by earlier. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But they couldn't duplicate the outside of the house, and that's why they still filmed here for the entirety of the 10 seasons. Mm-hmm. Yeah?
This is beautiful. So beautiful.
And do you guys know that Sean is a musician?
That's cool. What are you
playing? So he plays music all over.
Harmonica.
Harmonica.
Yeah. Because it's easier to pack up in the pocket. So I have guitar, ukulele.
That's
ukulele,
cool.
Just enough to get on TV.
What's your favorite song to play?
I don't think any of this.
The last one. The set, because I get to go home. It's usually Summer of the Rainbow, but I always got to throw that one. But I don't know, it just depends on how I feel.
Yeah.
If it's a Sublime song, or 80s song, or 90s song, so like, it just depends.
Aww.
I don't have a favorite song. Yeah, a particular one. Well, how long have you been playing?
Two and a half years.
Me too.
Oh.
I don't know.
I had him learn some of the Hawaii songs for them before. And he played Hawaii 5-0.
Nice.
That was a hard one. And not summer, Hawaii.
And then
Hawaiian wedding song. Oh, okay, right on. I don't even know that song. I mean, I know the song, but I've never been on anything, you know. So like, being on there is like pretty cool. Like when there's like a camera in front, I guess my thumb goes a little bit more higher. So it was just easier, easy being on the show. The only hard part is just waking up and then memorizing stuff, and then you know getting on your marks. But other than that, I guess. It's pretty cool.
Who's your favorite cameo to work with?
Obviously, you know, Cara Burnett. She was really cool.
Yeah.
Talked to her a couple times. Ziggy Marley and you see Lou Gossett Jr., Gladys Knight. You know, those two guys over there. They're pretty cool, you know, I guess.
How are they in your life?
They're cool. I mean, you know, I never talked to them that much because they didn't want to bother them. Because, you know, Scott always looks like he's angry.
Yeah.
I don't know why he's angry, but yeah. But then Alex, we always talk about, like, guitars and stuff. And nowadays, I think he has a lot more time to play his guitar. And, you know, and he's probably sleeping in, which is pretty cool. Sleeping in is always good, huh? It's really cool to see, like, just different people out there in the world. Not just, you know, America, but, like, other countries, you know, that watch the show.
Fans are all over the place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have people, you know, Germany. Australia, Austria. Wait, Austria and Germany is the same place, right?
No. Australia and Austria are two different countries.
Oh, okay.
Sounds very similar. One has an L and one doesn't.
I got a D- in geography.
No worries.
Same.
The Rock of Gibraltar.
Yeah. I was like, what? That's like in Looney Tunes. But it's really cool just to meet people. We've been doing this for a while, so.
Show them your tattoo. They have to be. They have to put makeup on it.
Like wardrobe and stuff, they can't have any logos or whatever. So sometimes I would use my own clothes. I probably use this shirt inside one of the whatever. But my tattoos, they have to call up all my tattoo artists. It's like, you know, they just, you know,
they're
just can't have any whatever.
Can sue, right?
Yeah. But there was one that they had to cover up, and it was this one right here.
Oh.
Right down my leg.
Oh.
And for some reason, they just covered up the spam letters. And they just left the can.
Yeah.
I'm like, why don't you just do the whole thing? But, yeah, but it was kind of weird. But other than that, they just left all the tattoos.
Then you were good on all your tattoos.
Yeah, it was all good. Yeah, like, nothing offensive or anything. I don't know if this is offensive. I'm not sure. But
you did not.
But other than that, it was really fun being on the show. And like, I was like 5-0, I did Magnum, and then I did something on Doogie. Kamea Aloha, they needed musician in the scene, so I'm like, I play one in real life, so I'll play one in TV.
Oh, McGarrett got tired.
McGarrett's tired of hearing the story. He's like, hey, shut up, Sean.
Ruthie, hi, it's Cousin Flippa again. Want to wish you a happy birthday. I hope you have a wonderful birthday today. I hope your birthday is filled with cake and beer and more cake and some water, because you need to hydrate after all that beer. Anyway, remember when we were at the McGarrett house? That was fun, huh? Really fun. And then remember when you were over here at the McGarrett house? See, this is you, Ruthie, watching yourself in the future while we're in the past. Isn't that cool?
That
it's kinda like we're time traveling, huh? Time traveling is cool, yeah, like you're in the DeLorean. Anyway, say hi to yourself, Ruthie, and say happy birthday, Ruthie.
Happy birthday, Ruthie.
Isn't that weird? You're watching yourself. Wow, that's cool. Anyway, much love and aloha to you, Ruthie. Both of you, Ruthies, the past and the future. Anyway, much love. Take care. Bye.
All these backdrops, you know?
Yeah.
So that script that you were going over, they actually filmed the scene right here under this tree. Oh. And that's the neighbor's house next door where Eddie the dog was. Remember that?
Yes, yes.
Get a better perspective of Mauna Lua Bay and Koko Crater and Koko Head Crater.
Here we are on the beach at McGarrett's house. And we're standing just a few feet from the water, the actual Pacific Ocean. And the water waves are breaking out there. And we're right here. And is that one? No, that's Coco Crater. Coco Crater over there.
Yes, you're on the beach. How cool is that?
And it's just stunning.
How are you feeling? How are you feeling?
Just wonderful. Just, yay. I want it to be like this forever.
Aww.
A forever memory. Get ready for heat.
Yeah.
And that humidity.
This has not been hot at all. It's
no?
Been so nice.
It's been nice.
We've had a lot of days.
We're having lunch at McGarrett.
We're the two from Texas.
That's so. Pretty rough. Thank you so much. My pleasure.
Thank you.
Can you believe that you're having lunch right here at McGarrett's house? He's going to be walking right through that door any minute.
Oh, no, he's right there.
Yeah, he's going to get off work. He's going to be walking through.
I wish I could say that, but it might be a jujitsu practice. They do have long days. They have to range from 12 to 18 hours. If you were to ask Sean his longest day, he would say it was 18 hours.
Wow.
It's the sound, lighting, and grip guys that show up on production at 5 a.m. And then the actors come in at 7:30 with their coffee in hand, bright eyes, bushy tail, ready to go while everyone's been working for a couple hours already. That's pretty standard for all production. You guys know that there were 4 sled dogs over the 10-year period? Well, so the Eddies that you see on the show, which is McGarrett's dog, there were 4 of them. And a lot of the times, whenever you're filming with animals or young children, that can be a challenge sometimes because they don't always ask do what you ask them to do when you ask them to do it. There was a time where they were filming in the front and they wanted Eddie to shake off the water like this. You know how they do it in slow motion where the water's doing this? And he just wouldn't do the scene. So they had to bring in the backup dog to do the scene so they could move on to the next location because there was another 100 crew members waiting for these guys to hurry up and finish with the dog here. But that's pretty standard whenever they're filming, again, young children or pets, right? Okay, from production, we get over to post-production, and this is where they go back to the film studio, and they edit everything down and bring it back together. It does take a couple of weeks to edit one episode of Hawaii Five-O, so that also takes up some time. And then there are 4 days to music score. And if you watch any of the shows that they film here in Hawaii, they utilize a lot of the local musicians here in Hawaii, which is good for them because it exposes their music to millions of people all over the world. And Sean also touched on that. The fan base for the show is very international.
That's
I did go to the set, that green rusted roof building. I walked, because all my friends worked on the show. Uh-huh. I walked in there and I opened the door and I go, no way. It just totally throws you off. You've seen the kitchen, you've seen the desk area, they have the dining room table, they have the living room and the mezzanine and everything else. But you would never know by looking at it from the outside that all of that was in there, really. You know what I mean? So I thought that was kind of interesting too.
Hey, we're just chilling in McGarrett's seat.
So where are we at?
McGarrett.
McGarrett's and the Pacific Ocean.
She's so giggly and lonely.
Right here is where the desk was situated. Do you guys remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is also where the dad was tied to the chair. Do you remember where before they killed his dad?
Yes, yeah.
Well, so yeah, they were like, oh, give me my brother and I'll give you your dad back. Oh, we don't negotiate with terrorists. And then this is where they offed him. But you know that they filmed that in the house because this was the backdrop that you saw.
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, the dining room table is there as well. We use it sometimes, but not very much. This whole roof above us here, there's a room. Yeah. You never saw it on the show. Because while you had a couple of hundred people here, all the crew members working on this thing, the owners would just stay upstairs. Wow. It's air conditioned, master bed, master bath, their office is up here as well. So that's where you see it. Wow. Come over here, take a look at the living room. Everyone kind of recognizes the mezzanine here as well, right?
Yeah.
So, for those of you who didn't use the restroom already, do you remember where McGarrett's room was?
Upstairs?
You would think it's upstairs, but it's actually on the ground floor.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so, you guys want to come take a look?
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah.
So, this is where they filmed a bunch of scenes with McGarrett and Catherine. If you notice, though, this is what architecture was like in the 1930s. A lot of ship lab. Doesn't it look like we're inside of a ship right now?
Yeah.
So, a lot of old character, right?
It does.
While they were filming here, as I mentioned, you would see all the movie trucks outside. Craft services where they fed all the cast and crew, and the porta potties are out there. The only people that were allowed to use this toilet back then, though, was Alex and Scott.
Oh.
Everybody else had to use the toilets outside. So when you get in there, make sure you look on the refrigerator, okay?
On the refrigerator.
What's the biggest group you've had?
About 13 people.
13.
You're trying to bring too many. You can't fit that many people in this house.
Oh,
or in this
Dad, look.
Oh.
So this was one of the characters that was on the show.
Yeah, that's Joe.
It was Joe White, right?
Yeah.
And then Gabriel, you remember him?
Yes. Oh, yes. Yes.
So he was the bad guy, kind of, sort of, right? And you can see Scott hanging out in the chair exactly where you had lunch today. So that's Dano, right? And then there's Suze Mirkatani, who you met earlier outside. She was raking the leaves. And then you can see Alex here, who played McGarrett. But I was telling them that after 10 seasons of filming here, the characters on the show and the owners of their property, they had genuine friendships. So they would have events and parties here all the time. And a lot of them would come with their significant others and their kids, and they would all just kind of hang out together, really, right?
So that is so cool.
Yeah.
But you can, that, because they keep saying Ohana,
Ohana.
The family.
Ohana.
Ohana, but you guys are an example of family.
Absolutely,
you really,
yes.
And this
we
all
take care
is,
of our
and
family,
I can tell that
sure.
Even you with your, you know, her here, and it's just really, really special.
But if you notice, it's pretty tight in here, huh?
Yeah. It is. How did they get the
cameras in here and also have all the cast members as well?
Yeah.
They never filmed in this kitchen. But the kitchen that you see on the show is modeled exactly after this one here. Although the sink is totally different. And I have more storyboard to share with you guys too. So this is the studio version of the kitchen that you just came out of. So as you can see, it's basically the same layout.
Yeah.
Right? That's where they got the inspiration from, French country style kitchen. But there are differences. The sink is totally different. Yeah. And this table in the middle is much smaller, so the cameras could get around as well. We also don't have two refrigerators here, and we don't have a hutch here. So that's at the studio, all of this here, right?
Okay.
But basically, it looks the same for the most part. You would see Alex sitting on a counter, going over his cases, or making waffles or pancakes. And also, we make that keto coffee with the butter in it, too.
Oh.
Some people swear by that, but it's not for me. Okay, this is the garage as you saw in the show.
Yes.
This garage in the front was a little too small to fit all this stuff, but also have that old school Mercury bomb of a car. Because back then, in the 60s, these cars were like big boats, right?
Yes,
so
yes.
You wouldn't be able to fit that in this garage. That's why this was at the studio. So all of this is in the green rusted roof building that I was pointing out to you as we were passing it by.
And the red toolbox.
And the chat box, exactly.
Yes.
So I'm gonna
red
flip this.
Little box that he...
That's where they got all the clues to go over and figure
Yes.
I'm gonna flip it over. Is that cool?
Yes.
Okay. This is the other side. And as you can see, this is all the studio, right? So they did have the desk, which they utilized quite often at the studio. They did have the dining room table, which they didn't really utilize very often, because whenever they had all the cast members, just imagine one Kame Kona here and one Flippa here, and you can't fit anybody else on the table.
Yeah,
so a lot of the Thanksgiving scenes that you haven't seen yet, which you will in the future.
I have seen the title, so we're coming close.
They filmed that outside so they could fit all the cameras around and also fit all the cast members in the, the table as well.
Yeah.
Okay, here's the living room. As you can see, same layout, but obviously the furniture is different. No Lazy Boy, no ottoman, and then no piano here too. Have you guys seen that one episode where they had the general who was here to testify against the other bad generals from Asia?
Yes.
And they had all these assassins dressed as police officers and SWAT in the front of the house.
Yes.
Which they filmed in the front. Mm-hmm. And then the 5-0 team takes this general's kids and puts them under the trap door under the stairs. And if you notice, there's no trap door here.
Yeah.
So that's how you know it was at the studio.
Okay.
Also, these stairs here, these are enclosed, while this one here is open, so that's how you know that it was at the studio as well. Okay, so when they used to film in the house and they would take all this furniture out, what they would do is take pictures of everything. And Suze wanted to test them one day, and she made a ball of rubbish and placed it over here by the entryway table. And so when they returned all of her furniture, that ball of rubbish was in the same exact spot that she left it at. Which just tells you that they pay attention to detail.
That is,
wow, you have to.
That is
really
say hello.
Of course.
I was when I say come in because if sometimes
he goes out.
Yeah.
Oh,
no, that's okay. It's okay. Well, that's fine. That's fine. You know what does damage the high heels, the stiletto heels. Yogi, say hello.
Hey, Yogi.
What kind of dog is he? Yogi is an English bred Labrador retriever. Oh. So they're bigger than the American field dog.
Yeah. Yes.
I think he's...
Does he smell lucky?
Yeah.
He might smell lucky on you.
You have a dog?
Yes, we have a Havanese.
Oh!
And
Yeah, he's a cutie.
How old is your dog?
Two. Oh,
there will
be three in October.
Yeah,
he's smile. How old is Yogi?
He's a young
Yogi.
Seven. Wow.
How much does he weigh? 100 pounds?
I'd say he's about 98.6.
Oh, thank you for showing that.
Hey, Yogi, loves
you,
hey,
buddy. Oh, what a
gentle giant.
He's my
dog's
best friend, by the way.
He's a great big.
What's your dog's name?
His name is
Honolulu. I tickle so much.
He's just a small, silky terrier.
He
tickles
so much.
So
he's small.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
He's like a small, medium size.
Oh, my goodness.
I just made jerky for him. Let me show you.
He's got some tricks.
Oh, my goodness.
Get the basket. He was a ring bearer at a party. Bring your basket and the ring boxes.
Oh,
his basket.
Wow.
Sit down and hold it. Hold. Give.
Okay, you'll be bound. Don't bow.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. I can't even do that.
Yes.
Oh my goodness.
You sit.
Good dog.
Who wants this?
Oh, me. Oh. Wow.
And Yogi wanted to show that at night after he pees for the last time, I have him help me close the house up. So, Yogi, can you close the door for me? Come close. Sometimes he won't do it. Yogi, come. Come close the door. Come. Yogi, don't get stubborn. Come on. You want this? Thank you, Yogi.
Well, he may or may not.
Oh, he did so good. Oh, my goodness.
Yogi, come heal.
Oh.
Go heal.
Oh.
And down.
Wow.
Stay.
Good dog, Yogi. Oh, you did so good.
Yogi. Hey.
You love dogs.
Yogi, pop, pop. Wait, don't chew your paws. He's itchy. His paws are getting itchy. Okay, stop that. Stop it.
Just keep some lip,
you know,
lip licking.
I might have something for you. How old are you?
10. Sit. Lay down. Good boy.
Yes, good dog.
What a dog!
He's a good dog. Wow.
Lay down.
Wow.
Sit.
Oh. Who wants a treat?
Who wants that, Yogi? You. Maybe you will go to feed her.
Tell him to close the door.
Hey, go close
the door. Yogi, close the door. Come on. Here, why
don't you walk over this way? Okay. Hey. Gotta let him
itch first.
Yogi, come on.
Hey, Yogi.
Hey.
Come on.
Yogi, close the door. Hey. Go close the door. Close the door, go close it.
Close
the door. Come on, close the door.
Fight this. Oh. Center there.
Here, you stand over here and say, Yogi, close the door.
Hey, Yogi, close the door.
All the way. All the way. Good boy.
Oh, good boy. Okay. Wow.
I have a surprise for you.
Okay.
Close your eyes and then open your hands and then you can open that up now.
Oh.
I only sure, and see, I don't have anything for everybody, that's but crazy. I had a few. And then here, see this one? It says here, Film Crew Season 4. So you can't buy these in the stores because only the film crew had it.
No
and then the back,
way.
See
see this, the volcano? It looks like a form.
Oh, yeah.
We haven't got a location, Honolulu, Hawaii. So you
wow,
have
thanks.
A very rare thing because you cannot buy them anywhere.
That's amazing. Oh, my goodness.
And I just had a couple of small ones, and that's what I thought.
Oh, my goodness. That's amazing. And we got to meet Yogi, too. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're very
what a
nice.
Privilege.
Aww. What a dog! What up, Yogi!
So here we are. We have been just having a little break from our tour, and now we are going to go to the shopping mall. It was an amazing tour, like beyond amazing. And Mama,
second largest shopping mall in.
I don't know if it's second, but
she said it was. It used to be the first until the Mall of America in Minnesota.
But man, this is Macy's in Hawaii.
I know, Macy's in Hawaii.
What could possibly go wrong?
Thank you.
Another one?
Yes.
Yes!
Big outdoor shopping mall, and we got Cocoa Puffs, we got jelly, we got donuts for tomorrow. I'm hoping they all get eaten, and that's the beginning of our shopping. So, but I am getting ready to eat. I'm getting hungry. My body is so out of whack, it's not even funny. And like, it's only 3 o'clock and I'm like, okay, dinner. But we're going to a really cool, a really cool food court. So we'll see. We'll see what my parents get.
So here we are at the legendary Honolulu Cookie Company.
Heard some great things about it. I'm looking forward to trying it.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Everything's better in Hawaii. Everything's bigger in Hawaii. Everything's better in Hawaii. That's better. You got a short chocolate chip macadamia shortbread. You gotta try it. Try it.
Mash it up and then you want to put the eye after the mash. You add water to the bucket
and turn it. Very flavorful. Amazing.
There you have it.
So what do we get?
So, dessert one, Honolulu Cookie Company from Hawaii. We got a shopping bag full of desserts. I'm okay with that. So these cookies, I'm not a shortbread cookie person, but these cookies are really good. So yes, can't wait to eat. Vintage Coffee, we found a place. So We got everyone ground coffee, so we'll see how they like it. Extra fancy for everyone. Here at our last time before our home, and we're going to Viola Shave Night. We got pina colada with strawberry and vanilla on the bottom with condensed milk.
Oh my
and
goodness.
And we gotta get yours.
Ooh, what'd you get, Jay?
I got blue raspberry and watermelon with condensed milk.
How does it taste?
Amazing.
That's good to hear.
Yum. I love it.
Chocolate peanut.
Yes, with ice cream and
here, I'll hold it for you.
Thank you.
Here, you can take your picture.
Okay, let's get our picture. There
wonderful, you. Wonderful.
I'm gonna take our picture. Thank you.
So here we are on day number 5, and we are here just to review our incredible day in Hawaii. And want to start off with Dwight. I would love to ask you what you had, what was special about today.
We went to the mall, the second largest mall of America, Ala Moana. And we were sitting there eating lunch. He said, I'm glad you shared your faith with me. That's what he said. And,
wow. But. So it was definitely a full day for all of us, especially Dwight. Mama dear, tell us about your day. What was one highlight of your day?
I would say I felt like a schoolgirl going to Hawaii 5-0. And it was an amazing day. There was, everything was just star, star, star. But being at McGarrett's house, sitting on the chairs, looking out over the ocean, was just with the family, was just awesome. And I didn't cry. I wanted to. I thought I would, but I it just was such a relaxing, just an amazing, amazing moment in time for me.
So,
birthday girl. What was the highlight of your trip?
I have two, and they were, the first was the tour, the Hawaii 5-0 tour that we went on. Just driving and seeing the sights of Hawaii and the beautiful weather that came with it, and the tour guide showing us the culture, the giving us all these facts, and it was just, it was really cool and awesome. And then my second is seeing Mom's face light up and glow, and while we were at McGarrett's house, and you know, all these precious moments, you know, are priceless and very precious. And yeah, that it was a really wonderful day. So
JJ, well, tell us about your day. What was special about day five?
So number one was meeting the dog at the house and getting these.
Oh my goodness. Where'd you buy that?
I did not buy it. I was given it.
Oh my goodness. That was super, super special.
So I actually am gonna have the same highlight as James. So all of a sudden, we were about to leave. We got all packed up. We were ready to go. And all of a sudden, we heard the door open. Said, hey, you wanna see Yogi? We're like, wait, a dog? Anytime we are offered to see a dog, we always wanna see him. So then the owner of the property opened the door, let James and me in, and then the dog came over and started doing some really cute little tricks. And then all of a sudden she said, hey, how old is your son? He's 10. She said, I might have a surprise for him. So all of a sudden she came out and got you this amazing shirt.
Yeah.
Very, very cool.
That's very cool.
And then all of a sudden she said, hey, what size are you? I said, I don't know, large, XL? Just depends on who's making the shirt, right? And she came back and she also gave me this shirt right here. Not only does it say Hawaii 5-0's Film Crew Season 4, but on the back, it also has the same thing. And it was really funny because tonight at the Ala Moana Mall, people were asking me if I was the film crew for Hawaii 5-0. The first time I just nodded. She took me very seriously. She said, oh, wow, we love your show. We watch it, it's great. Oh, okay. So then the second time we were at the cookie place and I said, oh, you film for Hawaii 5-0. I'm not gonna lie to her and say yes. Well, maybe the first time I kind of. Well, meanwhile, I said, shh. Well, she says your shirt says it. I said, shh, okay. So that was funny. And then tonight at the Disney store, when I was getting a souvenir for my amazing mother, got her spirit jersey, all of a sudden the lady at the counter said, oh wow, you filmed for Hawaii 5-0. I said, it's complicated. So then the hitter said, wait a minute, I've seen you in here a few times. How did you get that shirt? It's complicated. So it was kind of cool to not only get this amazing shirt from the owner of the McGarrett house, the, what is the Bear?
B-A-Y-E-R,
the Bear Estate. Mm-hmm. But also to kind of be recognized for something.
Such a cool compliment.
Yeah. That we received today on our tour. So, super special day here. And I guess if I had to rate this day on a scale of 1 to 10, I would give it a 5.
Oh.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye. Bye.